So he's back. He won't go away. Should I use this? Would that help be better? So, you thought you all were just going to come here and enjoy a nice concert and not have to work, but you're doing some singing yourselves, aren't you? And that's the best kind of singing, hymn singing. So, one thing I'd like to do, if you wouldn't mind, you might like to take a picture. Because you are a great audience, and I just have to take your picture.
So bear with me.
It's going to be hard getting you all in. I promise I won't leave. Maybe go like this or something. Yeah, there you go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to have to get this glorious piano in, too. Sorry, guys, I can't get you all in, but the lid is covering you. There we go. I got pastor in anyway. That's the most important thing. Okay. Some people might not believe that I played a big concert now with COVID, so I got to prove that I did.
Did we turn out good?
Huh?
Did we turn out good?
Yeah, you're great. Can I take you on the road? The church will pay all your expenses, of course. Okay, so now for some good Lutheran fun. No German refreshments, but we are going to do some Mighty Fortress. I've got a nice brand new prelude. Well, it's not that new. It's a couple of years old, I think. It's actually from CPH, Concordia Publishing House, and I thought it was just perfect for this occasion. It'll be a nice little prelude, and then after that, we'll stand and sing our great Lutheran anthem, A Mighty Fortress.
Thank you.
So, my line, there we go. I don't need these now. So, many of you may not know of something called the three B's. Has anybody heard of the three B's? The three B's, yes, of course, the musical people here would know what that is. In elementary school and high school a long time ago, you would hear that when music teachers were talking about the three greatest composers, and those are Bach, Beethoven, and Brahms. And surprise, they're all in the program tonight, or today. And so I just thought I would throw that little tidbit out there. Probably a lot of kids have never heard of the three B's. It's not three bumblebees or honeybees or anything. It's three musical composers, and that's the best way to remember these great musical geniuses that God has given us, actually. And Bach, in my opinion, is the greatest. Beethoven and Brahms are right behind. So this is the famous Moonlight Sonata. You'll recognize the first movement, I'm sure. The other two, maybe not so much, but they are equally as passionate as the first one.
Thank you. Thank you.
resist talking a little bit. I guess I left this on. Yeah. So part of my job as a musician is not only a performer, but I'm also an educator. I have about 15 students that I teach each week piano, and then I'm also a music director at a Lutheran church down in St. Louis. And so I guess one of the reasons I like to talk is because you all probably don't hear this kind of music live very much, if at all. In fact, I wonder how many of you have ever heard the Moonlight Sonata live. Anybody heard? Oh, that's great. Yeah, it's a pretty famous work and pretty common and familiar. So I guess I shouldn't be so surprised, but a lot of you may not have heard that. So it's good that we, as musicians, keep these pieces in front of you. And I hope that Pastor and the congregation here will have continued recitals in the future, and maybe even an organ recital at some point. You've got a beautiful instrument here. But the next composer is Johannes Brahms, and while he wasn't a Roman Catholic, I believe he lent, leaned toward evangelical in Germany at that time, although he was not the most religious person. But he could write some of the most beautiful, powerful music known to man. And he is of the Romantic period in the 1800s. And these two pieces in particular have been some of my favorites for many, many years. And at the suggestion of Mrs. Fairfield, I leapt at the chance to play the A major intermezzo, but then also I thought, well, let's play the Volante, because it's a very gorgeous work. So these are two famous pieces by Brahms.
Thank you.
while we have a little stage work up here, with the music desk coming on board again, we're coming to the close of the program, and again, I have to thank Pastor and John and Laura and all the people here at the congregation for having me come and play. It's really an honor and a privilege, and I feel blessed, and I hope you all do too, to hear this great music, and then also to be able to sing some hymns, and to be uplifted in our faith and inspired in our daily walk. Pastor mentioned, I think, something about what Luther said, Luther's, Bach, well, let's see, I'm getting confused now. I think it was Bach that said, music is for the refreshment of man and the glory of God, to paraphrase his words, and that's certainly true. So I hope you've enjoyed the program. I've enjoyed preparing for it over the past 3 months as we start to come out of COVID, and it's been a pleasure to meet all of you, to worship here this morning, and to come to Sycamore and learn all about DeKalb and all the history around here. Last night I was reading all about Major General DeKalb. He was an actual Revolutionary War soldier who came over from Europe to help us fight, and he actually died in the battle for our independence against the British. And it's fitting that a lot of our towns in the United States are named DeKalb. Let's see here. Oh, okay. So we have Franz Liszt, chorale, Was Gott tut. Well, I better put these on. Anybody speak German out here? Ooh, good. I hope to talk with you later. I hope my German is pronounced properly. Was Gott tut, das ist wohlgetan. What God ordains is always good. And that's the name of one of our hymns. But there's a story behind this piece also, this chorale that Franz Liszt wrote. Franz Liszt is one of the most respected and one of the most prolific piano composers ever. And he was considered the greatest and may still be considered the greatest pianist, although there's a lot of them running around now. He was just phenomenal at performing. He retired at the age of 35 or so as a concert pianist. He played all over Europe and donated a lot of money to charities and the wives of composers who had died, and the composers who died and the wives who are still living. And he was a very generous man. Again, he was a Roman Catholic by upbringing. And he had three children. And over the course of his life, two of them died. They lived into their 20s, from what I read. And so they were young adults, but his daughter and one of his sons passed away. And of course, that would leave him grief-stricken, as it would most of us, all of us probably. And to lose one and then the other, and then also his good friend, I believe it was Wagner, passed away. So he was stricken with death. And so he wanted to, I guess, commemorate their lives, and so he wrote this tremendously difficult piece of music called Variations on the theme by Bach. You're not going to hear that theme. That is a very sad theme resembling the crucifixion of Jesus. But he wrote this entire piece of music for piano called Variations, and it's highly difficult to play, difficult to memorize, but yet I decided to work on it a few years ago, and because it was based on a theme by Bach. And I get to the end of the piece, and all of a sudden, out comes this chorale that you're going to hear in a few minutes. It's only about a minute and a half long, but it just kind of struck me as odd. Here's a Roman Catholic borrowing one of our Lutheran chorales again, and he puts it at the end of this mightily complex piece of music, and it's like the sun comes out and his grief is lifted at the end of the piece, and he says, well, it's God's will. What God ordains is always good. So it's a tremendous witness that this man leaves us with his music. And he did actually, later in his life, I think, take the holy orders to become a Catholic priest, although he never completed that. And I think he lived into his 80s. But anyway, that's a little background about this piece. I'm only going to play the last minute or two of this long work. And this is the chorale, and I'll use that as our prelude before we sing our last hymn, What God Ordains Is Always Good. And again, many thanks for you coming out, taking the time to hear a concert and hear me and put up with all my talking. So I hope you enjoy these last few pieces. can have a seat. I was thinking that was kind of an easy way to get a standing ovation. Well, this is another very famous piece that you all will probably recognize right away. But again, maybe some of you have heard it live, but maybe many of you haven't, especially the younger ones here. So I think word will get around what this piece is.